all day waiting for my marlin.
Oh, here he is, here he is.
Seen one on the scan. Yep. Whip it. Who's on?
Wind that handle fast. Wind it.
Tight. Just watch your fingers when it comes tight.
I'm on a road trip in far north Queensland with my apprentice Jake and runners-up Danny and Nikki. And today, we're leaving our little stabycraft behind to head out to the Great Barrier Reef aboard the Hellraiser.
Well, right now, we're fishing for our bait. And when you look at the size of the tackle and the size of the lures that we're using to catch our bait, it gives you some idea of the size of the fish we're after. Here you go, mate.
Yeah. Got a bit of weight in them.
Do you want to put it in there? Okay. I'll chuck that in there.
Yeah, why not?
Need a gimbal bout to fight our bait. How's that? Oh, is it a Spaniard? Spanish mackerel.
Matty, this is our bait.
Whenever you...
And this is the biggest fish of all this whole trip.
I know. Look at that. Right, how's that? Stand back. Okay, stand back. There's treble hooks here, guys. Treble hooks here. How's that for a bait?
I think that's the biggest fish of the trip.
It's the biggest fish of the trip. How is that when you catch your bait and you want to get your photo taken with it? Do one where you push the teeth towards and drop it and just turn the head but not the body. Yeah, there you go. Okay, flex the biceps, flex the biceps. Nice work. Here we go. You're on. Nikki. Oh, no, that was it. No, let go. Stand by. I love fishing the reef. Here we go, on over here, Nikki. And this is why I love fishing the reef. The bait fishing is exciting. We're catching big fish. You just push that drag up just a little bit. Lift and wind, yeah, lift and wind. That's it. Good girl.
This is what it's all about.
Man, mate. Here we go. What have we got? Shark mac, have we? Here we go, look at that. Shark mac, another bait. Stunning looking bait. Rightio. Now, I think I was at about, this is really exciting, and I love fishing the reef. And if I had to choose a form of fishing, look at that, there you go. And this is why. It starts off, you catch your baits, they're big fish, you're bringing them in, they're interesting looking fish, they're fast fish, they got teeth. And then you're using them for baits to catch giant black marlin. And I've got to say, if I had to choose a form of fishing and a place to fish, it would be here on the Great Barrier Reef doing exactly this. It's a whole day experience. And we're on a very good boat with a very good crew.
Just a little scaly mess, I think.
Do you want to gaff it?
I don't want to bugger your bait by gaffing it in the guts. There you go, well done. Okay, everyone back, everybody clear. Another Spaniard, another nice bait. You beauty. Not only are they nice baits, they're in fact great eating the Spanish mackerel. We had fish and chips on our first night here. Spanish mackerel, superb. Although I'd much rather feed it to a giant black marlin. Good boy, Jagger boy. Okay, so that's one of our baits, Sue. Is that a brine that you're putting it in? So it's a little bit firmer, it'll hold together better when we're towing it.
Yeah.
Very cunning, interesting. See how much care is taken of these baits, because they're so important, you know? Everything's done methodically.
Okay, we're just gonna rig the Spanish mackerel as a skip bait. We run him in nice and short. We might even put him on this hand line contraption here.
There we go. There you go, Danny.
Not as big as the last one. A little bait. Nice size.
Okay, Jagger boy.
Jake, Danny and Nikki are keeping busy and having fun catching bait. But if they think this is good, they're in for one heck of a surprise if we get to see one of the marlin that live here on the reef that suck down these fish holes.
Nice size bait.
Still can't get it into my head that we're actually going to be using these as bait fish to catch something bigger.
Here we go. Nikki. Okay. Oh, double hook up. You want the gimbal belt? Okay, you're under, guys. You're crossed over, I think.
Yeah. Okay, under or over?
Over. Under.
Little doggy.
I haven't got enough drag here to do anything, eh?
Might be a little doggy, you reckon,
something.
GT,
baby.
GT?
Maybe.
got a bit more go than the other ones, eh?
Gonna get a look at it soon.
Oh,
look,
there's something else behind him.
There's a fish. Get him in, mate. Get him in. What? Just mouth gap, mate. Look. Shark on him. There's a shark on him. Get the pole camera going. Woo! He's getting upset. Oh, he's not a little one either. What is that? Is that? It's a barracuda after him. Come around here, Jake. Come around here, Jake. It's foul hook, which what gave us all the trouble. And there's a barracuda. Out here on the Great Barrier Reef, there's like a million scenarios of life and death being carried out. You're either eating something or something's trying to eat you. And here's a classic example. This barracuda is only about the same size as that scaly mackerel. And it's tucking into it. Look at that. Look at those bites that it's taken out of there. Those are those teeth that I've been talking about. Everything on the reef has got teeth. And if we just hold that there, we might get another look at that barracuda just coming in. He's showing no respect for the boat at all. Let's let him out of it. We'll see if he has another chew on him, eh? Here he goes. He's biting him now. Oh, and he took off. Now let's have a look at this. Now you can see here what that barracuda's done. Just come up with those razor sharp teeth. You'd swear a shark has attacked that. Now you can see the barracuda here. He's had a taste of blood and we've dropped a little bit of foam overboard. And the barracuda's even looking to attack that. That is amazing. That barracuda was barely bigger than this, and look what he's done to it. Unreal. And there's a barracuda. So many.
Out here all day, waiting for my marlin.
Oh, here he is, look, here he is.
See, one on the scat. Yep. Whip it. Who's on?
Wind that handle fast. Wind it.
Big baits have been rigged and set. The anglers have been given a demo in the chair, and all we need now is a giant black marlin.
Now what we have here is your typical giant black marlin setup. We've got a couple of 130-pound Shimano Tiagras towing a couple of baits out the back for a marlin. These guys are going to be taking turns in the chair, so if a marlin strikes and it's their time, they're going to be on and fighting the fish. However, I'm chucking out my big bait attached to the old trusty electric fence reel. That's gonna be skipped along out the back. If something eats it, I'm gonna be fighting it by hand on a hand line. It's something that I'm equally excited and anxious about. More excited though. Jake, you wanna get yourself a glove on standby? Okay, if this stays wet, it'll stay nice and cool, because if we get a bite, it's going to be racing.
Yeah, mate.
The black marlin is actually the fastest fish in short bursts in the ocean. Now, we've seen the size of that great big huge bait that we're trolling out there. Now, the marlin are quite capable of eating a bait that big, but we've got to let them eat it. So, this is the system that we're using. We've got our bait skipping along out there, which is held up by our outrigger in that clip. Now, if the marlin comes up and bites that, it's going to release from that clip. The line then comes down to here to another clip, which releases, and we've got this, a whole big belly of slack line in the water. So as soon as the marlin bites, all the clips undo, and then all the slack line just drops back nicely and gives that marlin a chance to eat the bait. Once he's got the bait in, we then need to hold on, set the hook, and from there, well, so it gets exciting. Stay quite close to me, because if I somehow get both hands wrapped up or something, just cut me out, mate. Now, this is the part where the waiting starts. You know, after all of the initial excitement, catching the baits, everything's happening. We come out here and we troll these baits, and we've just got to wait. So, just to help these guys and give them some anticipation, I've just regaled the yarn of the first time we fished here, and the biggest fish I ever saw took 5 days of doing this before we got the bite from it. I happened to be watching it at the very moment that this thing just boom came out of the water. I couldn't believe the size of the fish, and then we had a to and fro battle with this fish in quite rough seas for about 3 or 4 hours. We actually got it on the leader 2 or 3 times. I was so fired up that I couldn't leave the cockpit. There was no way that I was going to miss a second of it.
I am literally pissing my pants now. I've been hanging on to this for about the last half hour, and mate, I'm not going anywhere.
fact, I forgot all about making a TV show. It was just all hands on deck to get this one huge fish. I mean, at that point in my fishing career, I'd caught around about 1,000 marlin, and you tend to lose a little bit of that adrenaline buzz, but it all came back with this huge fish. But we're all there, hands on deck. We got it to the leader a couple of times, and then our worst fear happened. The sharks got it. And it wasn't until we got the head of this marlin that we'd been fighting for a few hours that we got a real gauge of the size of the fish. So I've just regaled all of these guys that story just to give them the motivation to watch those lures, because you will not see a greater sight in fishing than seeing a marlin charge up out of the water and eat one of those big baits. Come on!
Tuna.
You can see splashing out the back there, a shoal of tuna. In other words, food for marlin. So we're definitely in the right spot.
Is it a bite?
Nah, maybe not. It just seemed to trip out pretty hard, eh?
Yeah, come out quick. That's good.
Leave it there. Sean, leave it there.
You saw a splash? Oh, it might have been a chop off. Might have been a woe. Nah. Okay, we've just had a knockdown on our back bait. We don't know what it is just yet. We've seen a splash.
Hey, took it.
Bait's gone. Bait gone. Wahoo. Razor sharp teeth. It's come up. Whack. Bait gone. All the deckhands' hard work stitching up baits disappeared just like that. And it can be a real problem here when you're marlin fishing on the reef. The wahoo just chopping all your baits off. Bit. Who's on? Undo the straps, undo the straps.
Wind that handle fast, wind it.
They're tight, just watch your fingers when it comes tight. Oh, he spat it, has he?
Sir, stop.
That was a bite. Steve spotted it from up in the tower, caught it on the scad. It's come up, it's eaten it. It looks like it's busted the bait off. Look at that, it's just smash the scad. We've come back with just the head. At least we know they're here.
Bit of an anti-climax, unfortunately. Thought I was going to be my first marlin. Damn it.
One of those massive wahoos, mate.
Yeah. Don't get your foot around that line.
Just had another one pop, mate. It's all good.
It's getting chopped.
So I'll check this one then, because it might be chopped too, eh?
Yeah.
Bugger. Oh, I thought I could have been on the hand line then. Certainly keeps the crew busy, does the old wahoo. Yeah, it's been hit. You can see there, the laceration around the tail. How the wahoo hunt when they attack big prey like this, is they come up with their scissor blade teeth that run past each other, bang, whack the tail off, and then they come back and feed. And that's what's happened to that bait too.
That wahoo was about 8 foot long.
What do you got? Got him on, whoa!
Thought I saw it twang, but not trip out a second ago, just as you were climbing down. It's been chopped. Another bait chopped. Here we go. Another bait, all that work, look at that. Chopped, clean chopped by a wahoo.
Sean, don't put another one out unless you've got a stinger in it.
Okay, so Steve, the skipper, has suggested that we run another hook right down to the back of the bait, because we're getting so many chopped off by the wahoo. At least we've got a hook down the back there where they come and attack the tail. We should be able to catch one at least. Then we can show you how they operate. Hopefully in the meantime a giant black marlin comes up and eats the bait on my hand line. That's what I'm really hoping. But no.
Alright, it's basically what we've done here. After chop off after chop off. Wahoo, we've placed a J hook in the tail. Still a circle on the front. It's quite light gauge wire this, so the idea is if we do hook a marlin on it, we still get him on the circle with any luck, because this should break away quite easily. If we get a wahoo, we'll go a little bit lighter on the drags and hopefully we'll get him in the boat as well. Anyway, he's fishing.
There you go, very cunning rig. Look at the all-rounder. I like this crew, they're slick. Very slick, these two.
Oh, got one on this one.
Who's on?
Who's on?
Mine. Pressure.
Double. Look at that, chopped, and it's missed the hook, eh? Gnarly, everything but the hook. Bugger. Running repairs. That's how important the baits are here. That bait there was the one I had on my hand line, and a wahoo's come up and nipped the tail. So Sue, quite cleverly, probably as skilled as a surgeon, repair that tuna. That's how precious these baits are here. You'll notice that's not the bait that we had out this morning. It was the great big Spanish mackerel. Well, we decided to pull it in and put the tuna out for a little while, and that's because the big bait attracts the big fish, which come late in the day. And we thought, didn't we, Shannon, we'd just chuck the big bait, put it on the bench, let it cool down in the cool tank for a little while, because it wasn't performing. You know, sometimes your star player just needs a bit of time on the bench just to get him.
He's a little bit of enthusiasm.
That's right.
That's chill right. Him back down in the brine and put him back out for that prime time bait.
Exactly.
Usually, yeah, late afternoon bait with a tide change. We just wait for things to happen.
That's right. Impact player like Sunnyville, you know? Sit him on the bench and get him angry for a while and then put him out there at the right time.
Alright, now we don't want to push that lever up above 8.
Okay.
We're going to leave these other baits out and winch it up the middle?
I think so.
Barracuda! Jumbo. Swing them on in, mate. Well, there you go. We caught one of the culprits. That's what that stinger hook at the back is for. To catch these critters that have been biting our baits off. And that J hook has done just as we expected, although that is a barracuda, not a wahoo this time. There you go, Nikki. Barely put a bend in that fishing tackle, but
yeah.
We caught one of the culprits. It's been ruining our baits, if nothing else.
5 more minutes, cease fishing.
Come on.
I've been out here all day waiting for my marlin.
You haven't been out here all day though. You've barely been out here, you've been sitting in the air conditioning.
Yeah, but out on the ocean.
Oh yeah, oh, fair enough then. That's us, innit? One of the bonuses of the marlin not turning up and eating your baits is that any of the baits that have been unused and have stayed in the brine all day, you can eat them. This one here, Spanish mackerel, superb eating. We'll batter this one up, it'll be dinner tonight. And there's a lot of meat on these fish.
A lot of the gear and techniques in this episode have changed. And of course, we've had countless more fishing adventures. So to catch up with the latest tips and techniques, as well as our latest fishing action, check out ultimatefishing.tv and download the Ultimate Fishing app, so wherever you go, you've got access to our entire catalogue of tips, rigs, techniques, and location information. And it's all available free at ultimatefishing.tv.